Hi guys, and welcome to another Bootstrap for Web Design video. This is Jamie from System22 and WebDesignerTechTips.com. In this video, we're going to sort of continue on playing with our navbar up here. In the last one, we put in this linear gradient here so that you could see your picture at the top. And also, you could still see all your links when you scroll down here. That's a pretty good option. It's very easy, simple bit of CSS as you saw in the last video. But what if we want to have this completely transparent, and then when it gets down to here, after the hero section there, when it gets to here, we want it to be a nice color, let's say this blue color. So at the top it's transparent, when we get down to here we want to make it blue. Well, it's not difficult to do. We do have to write a bit of JavaScript for that, though. But like I say, it's not too difficult. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's have a look. What I'm going to do is I'll put this back to being transparent. So if we open our bracket software. There's our background with the linear gradient right there. Let's just put that back to transparent. Okay, that's fine. Quick save, go back to the site, make sure it's done what we wanted it to do. Yeah, now that's completely transparent. You can't see it at all there, although those links are still there. All right, so what we want it to do, it's transparent now, and we want it to be transparent all the way down there, but when it gets to here, we want to be able to see it. So we want this, we're just going to choose this blue color background for it. And I think the red would be too much, so yeah, let's stick with that blue. So what I'm going to do is, I've got to write a bit of JavaScript here. So let's go back to our brackets. I've got to add another CSS class, and I'll call this class background.scrolled. So it's going to be bg dark dot scrolled, no gaps, open and close some curly brackets. And in this one, we want to actually give it a background color, so let's just copy that. And the color, that blue color that we used there, was 10CACA, I believe. Don't know if that'll let us have it, will it? Yeah, 10CACA. So let's use that color, back to our brackets. That looks right. So we've got transparent and we got, one might as well spell that right, dark. BG dark. So we've got BG dark and we've got BG dark scroll. Now comes the fun bit. We've got to actually write some JavaScript. And I'll try and paste this JavaScript below the video if it'll let me. I think it should let me. Sometimes browsers are a bit weird about letting you post that sort of stuff. So if we go to the bottom where our scripts here, here are all our scripts. And I will give it a little title here. And to do that with scripts, it's a little tag like that, exclamation, couple of hyphens there. And I'll say just so anybody that's has to work on this after me can find that bit of script easy, or this bit of script. So let's open some script tags. And let's start writing some script. Well, what do we want it to do? We want it to function. We want to focus on the window, and we want it to do something when it scrolls. So we always start with the dollar sign. open some round brackets. And we want the window. And what do we want it to do? We want it to scroll, so that's dot scroll. And the function that we really want to use here, so we open another little round bracket. And there's the function right there, but we want to write our own function. And again, just open and close some round brackets there. Then we want to open a curly bracket after that and tell it what we want it to do within these curly brackets. So let's just move down a line, give it a bit of space, and start with another dollar sign because we want it to work on the nav bar. So all I do is put nav in some single inverted commas there. So we want it to be working on our nav bar up here, nav on this section. And we want it to switch between those two classes that we created, background dark scrolled. And to do that, we have to tell it to toggle, which is a way for, you know, that it knows to switch between them. So we're going to say toggle. And it's the class, so we say class no gap, capital C. Got to open some more round brackets. Then we want to target this scrolled element that we've got there. So again, we're going to put those in some single inverted commas. And then after that, we want a comma and we're basically telling it to do this. So we want a dollar sign. This. Like I say, I'll put this down below because this is a little out of the scope for most of my videos. And scroll top. We want to make it larger than or more than. When it's more than, let's just guess. I'll say 800. We'll have to adjust that. Let's just close out that curly, that round bracket there and semicolon. And let's just put a semicolon off that in case we want to add some more. Save that and let's see if that actually works now. So it should toggle between those two classes, the transparent and the blue. So we save that back to our site, refresh, start scrolling down. There it is, it's popped that blue in. It's a little bit high up there. Could probably do with a 300 or so. And it pops in instantly. So let's just give it let's ease it in, say 750 mils or 3/4 of a second, just to make it not quite so jump in. So if we go back up to here, let's put it here. We'll give it a transition. We'll try 750. This is in milliseconds, so that'll be 3/4 of a second. And we'll have it ease in. Keep it all nicely in line, control S to save. And we said we wanted to add about 300 pixels, didn't we? So 8, 9, 10, 11. So let's try 1100. Save and back to the site. Let's go back up to the top. Refresh and start scrolling down. Oh, maybe a little bit too late there. You can see it's taking about 3/4 of a second to appear. So, a little bit. See, you can't read it there. If they happen to stop there, they're not going to be able to read it. So, we want it happening just a little bit before that. So, let's go back and just tidy that up. Let's call it about 1080, 20 pixels less. Back to the site. Let's go back up to the top again. Start scrolling down. Think, why wouldn't that happen just a little bit faster? So let's change that timing, say 1/2 a second instead. Control S, back to the site. Let's go back to the top and refresh. And let's start scrolling down. I'll use this little bar at the side. Perfect. You can see it all the way now. Could even shave off a few more pixels there. Excellent. Yeah, I'm happy with that. That's absolutely fine. So you've got transparent all the way down. Boom, when you get to the end of the hero section, turns to that blue color. Just what we wanted. So there you have it. There's how to change your navigation color on scroll using a bit of JavaScript and CSS. I hope you found that useful. If you have, please like and subscribe. If you're interested in web development, take one of our courses below. We've got some huge discounts for our YouTube subscribers. There's also some great free courses down there, so do take a look. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.